This is the Walthamstow Tapestry, and the original inspiration, I suppose, was with the most famous piece of textile art in Britain is the, oh, it's not in Britain now, but to British people, is the Bayeux Tapestry, which is the, it's a large embroidery depicting the invasion of the Normans into Britain in 1066. So this, though, is a depiction of the invasion of marketing into our brains. And it depicts the seven ages of shopping, I suppose, and every incident on this 15-meter tapestry is underlined or titled, if you like, by a different brand. And these brands, they are not associated with their product, so when you see a brand that you're familiar with, perhaps like there's one that everybody would know, Nike. I haven't necessarily put it next to someone with running shoes on, but I just think that, and I also haven't put it in the same typeface as the Nike logo, so that people only have the emotional resonance of the brand in their minds. And so it's like a kind of, well, these are the mythic gods of our modern world. So in the past, people would have looked at a tapestry and it would have been classical stories of myths and religions, and our myths and religions are often bound up around brands. In the middle is the kind of Madonna of the handbag, because the handbag is very much the kind of, I think, the archetypal consumer item. If you go to a department store, the handbag is there in front. You have the handbag, it is the most upfront item of consumer status. You put it on the table and it says, oh my God, you have a Prada handbag. And so this woman has been queuing for her Chanel handbag for a long time, and she's very happy, and she holds it like the Christ child in her arms, because she is so happy she finally has her Chanel handbag. At the beginning we have all the brands that I would associate perhaps with my childhood, and at the other end is the ones I would associate with old age more. We have a kind of two paths of life. I suppose they kind of represent the kind of organic, intuitive path of life and the more intellectual part. But I think that's just that I wanted two lines. I mean, often my ideas I have after I've finished the work. You know, I'm not one of these artists that has an idea and then illustrates it. So therefore, I probably just thought, oh, I need two long stripes going across, you know. Often I think of things, I think I'll make something yellow today, and then I think up what I'm going to do it about later, you know. So with this, I started with, I had a book launch, I wanted something to stand in front of when I had a book launch. You know, like they have it, when you go to a big press launch, they have like a logo board, you know, with saying the sponsor of the event on it. Mm-hmm. And so this was my starting point. But then, I got into the idea of brands, and then the way that brands are in our life, they're invading our mind. And so that relates to the Bayeux Tapestry, which was about the invasion of the Normans. And like I said before, this is the invasion of marketing into our minds, and how emotionally, when we look at these unadorned words, the words that, you know, Warner Brothers, Barclays, Pret-a-Manger, Adidas, Timberland, all these brands, we immediately have little sparks of emotion going off, because they've been put into our mind by advertising. And so a lot of the power of the piece has already been put there by all the marketing people.